Hey, Bill here. I originally started this video for my own personal use, to help me visualize the mathematics of gear cutting. My intent was to use the math derived by these videos to help update the Kithera program on the Glenview software website. But as the math unfolded, it seemed to me that these videos may help others understand the shape of involute spur gears. Thus this video. To be clear, my interest is in all things that compute. That includes using transistors to build computers, but that also includes things like mechanical adding machines and orreries. This was what motivated me to build a Kithera app in the first place. And to me, this is an extension of all the other videos and tutorials on the Hacking Den, as it describes different ways man have built computing devices to help us understand the world around us. I wish to note that I am just some guy on the internet, and I'm sure there are much better explanations for the geometry of involute gears. With that disclaimer out of the way, let's talk gear geometry.
And let us start our story with a wheel rolling along a line. We'll use these blue dots to show the line as it passes by our wheel. The position of the blue dots is governed by this equation. The position along the x-axis is the angle times the radius of the circle. The position on the y-axis is simply the radius. If you're not comfortable with vector math, there are a number of wonderful tutorials on YouTube. See the show notes for more information. We'll rewrite the equation using A for angle and R for radius. Now let's consider this from the point of view of the circle. As a line passes back and forth across the circle rotates. From the circle's point of view in the middle of the screen, the entire coordinate system and line rotates around us. The equation that governs the path of our blue dot is the prior equation rotated around by this rotational matrix, R. We can rewrite this equation to a more familiar form. This then governs the position of the blue dot as the wheel rotates from the perspective of the wheel. And if we plot this, we get this curve called an involute curve around our circle. Involute curves have all sorts of interesting properties, and there are plenty of articles on Wikipedia and elsewhere describing these properties. Now, suppose we're interested in the path drawn not by the point on the line, but by some offset from the point on the line. Rewriting our involute equation, we get the following expression. And we can plot each of these curves as we offset to the left or to the right of our original point. For points outside of our circle, they make these beautiful swooping shapes. For points inside the circle, they cut these interesting loops. As an aside, I know this differs from the mathematics offered in other gear cutting books, but bear with me, hopefully this will make some sense in a moment. Now suppose we want to know the shape formed not by a single point, but by a line segment connecting two points offset from our line. We can see a line segment below our line forming this interesting shape connecting our two loops. And if we draw a line segment from below to above our line, they create these interesting shapes. Now suppose instead of a circle along a line, we want to figure out the shape of a gear along a rack. Rotating to show the point of view of our circle, we see the same familiar paths we were drawing using our equations earlier in this video. This means if we were to figure out the shape along the paths that cut into our circle and redraw our circle as this shape, the gear shape works perfectly as a gear along our rack. Lines of force push against the teeth as the rack moves along our gear, rotating our gear along with it. And there are a number of numeric methods that can be used to calculate the specific shape of this gear. See the show notes for more information. Now, there is an interesting property about the shape of our gears. If our rack is symmetrical, that is, if we can flip it over and have it be the same, then any gear of any size we cut with this rack will mesh with our original gear. The rack that defines this gear is determined only by three parameters: the height of the rack, which is customarily set in most gears to a predetermined value, as shown in the show notes; the pitch angle of the gear teeth, usually 14.5 degrees or 20 degrees, and the pitch, that is, the distance between the adjacent teeth on our rack. This is also called the circular pitch because it coincides with the distance between two teeth on our gear. Any two gears cut with a rack with the same three parameters will successfully mesh and work together well. We can make another interesting observation. As gears get larger, the teeth shape converges to the pointed shape of the teeth on the rack. Less and less material needs to be cut from each gear to achieve its shape. So, for a sufficiently large enough gear, the geometry of its teeth mesh with the inside of the teeth of the larger gear. This implies that for a sufficiently large enough outer gear, we can use the same tooth geometry to describe an internal involute gear, the outer ring gear for a planetary gear system. In this video, we describe the equation of a point as it moves across a circle. We extended this equation to show the path a point takes from the point of view of a circle, and we extended this to show the curves as a tooth of a gear cutting rack cuts across a gear. We showed how two gears cut with the same rack will mesh correctly, and we showed that the same geometry can be used to create an inner involute gear. Thanks for watching.